Hey everyone, Dagosif here, and as you can see, we are back in Dragon Age Inquisition. Now, the last video I did on this was sort of my impressions on the game as it sort of plays, the gameplay itself, and my sort of opinions on the game and the combat and how they sort of evolved over the last. I guess back then it was like 72 hours I've been playing this game altogether. So what I wanted to do this time is just a short video on talking about some of the technical improvements that have been made recently with the most recent patches, or the most recent patch and hotfix. The hotfix is only for PC, and only it was an issue that was only affecting the PC. But it was basically overly shiny hair. It was a really real small, real dumb little bug, really, which didn't affect everyone as well. It only affected like certain NPCs, or it did on my system. That's all I noticed. But BioWare, surprisingly, put out like a workaround really quickly, like within, it would have been a few hours or so, and that did the job. That actually fixed it. But they actually put out a hotfix within like 2 days or so from the actual problem being noticed in the patch. So that was pretty good. That's some amazingly quick work there. I suppose, seeing as it only affected PC, it's a real quick problem to just sort of find, lock down, and then obviously because Dragon Age Inquisition is only on Origin on PC, then and Origin is obviously owned by EA, and BioWare is a division of EA, then they could probably get that patch just out there really quickly, I would assume. I suppose that's one good thing about having a publisher having their own platform for games, at least on PC anyway. Anyway, so that was kind of cool. Now, you know, that was good to see like something get fixed so quickly, especially considering it wasn't even a big like game-breaking issue. It was just like this kind of small graphical glitch, really. But it's still impressive to see that they got dealt with so quickly. Right then, so as you can see, I'm playing with mouse and keyboard because I just kind of wanted to give these controls a go again. And after a bit of research, I'm seeing like a lot of things which my like small complaints with the controls. I was thinking, well, I'll try and get around to trying out keyboard and mouse again. And then actually, after going through the key bindings, actually seeing an awful lot of stuff here that I was wondering about, like auto run. And things like interact, and obviously because I was playing this game for such a long time on controller, I actually forgot about all these controls, and I never really learnt them, so I've sort of been relearning these. And yeah, I actually don't mind the keyboard controls. The keyboard and mouse controls. I wouldn't really want to play with them all the time. I'm still quite happy with the controller. This still feels very much like a controller type game for me. Probably as I'm not much of an MMO player, I would imagine. But, you know, having auto run is nice. And where's the interact key? That's the F as interact. I don't know why I never really saw that before, but not having to click on everything and just being able to run up to it and press F. Like with a controller, when you just run up to it and press A, that's kind of what I want. And they've actually, in the most recent patch, the patch 2, there's a whole host of fixes in there, which I'm not going to go through individually, of course, because there's way too many. And not all of them affect PC. Some of them affect everyone. Some of them just affect PS4 and so on and so forth. One of the little changes they made is that interact the F key, or interact actually just automatically takes everything from the like loot loot boxes now and all that kind of thing. So that's kind of cool. That's a nice little change. That means that, you know, you don't run up to something, press F, and then have to like mouse over to take all or to do individual things. It just means you can run up to something and just double tap F, like you can on the console. It's a real small, almost dumb thing, really. I almost don't want to really mention it, but it's just kind of, for me, for the way I play, that's just kind of a nice thing. We're not going to go over there. I'm just running around here for performance and all that sort of reasons, really. We're just here because, well, this is an area where there's a bit of combat and we can try things out. So, as you can see, I'm mouse wheeling all the way out here, and we're not going into tactical view. And that's because, if we go again into the options menu, there's been a nice little change, again, with patch 2, that tactical camera and mouse wheel, you can actually untick that now, so that when you zoom all the way out, you don't automatically go into tactical view, which I can imagine for PC players is kind of a godsend. Because, you know, some people, they just like to be all the way zoomed out. And just zooming out and then automatically going to tactile view, which is not what you want to do, that could be kind of annoying. So being able to turn that on and off is kind of a big deal, I think. Although it's still somehow doing it there. Let's state that off. Oh wow! Now I can't get out of it. Okay, well this is a weird little issue, isn't it? Let's go back into options. Hey, this is kind of interesting that this happened. Let's turn that back on. Right, let's go back out and back out. Right, let's zoom in. There we go. And then go back into options and gameplay. And turn that off. There we go. Now, is that a bug? Is that a bug that needs to be fixed, or is that just how it goes? There we go. No longer a thing. That's obviously search. Where's tactical view? Actually, I forget where tactical view is. It's T, isn't it? There we go, T, you see. And unfortunately, tactical view, it doesn't seem to have been tweaked that, like, zooming out is done by just moving the mouse up and down. Like, the mouse wheel doesn't zoom in and out. That feels like a missed opportunity. And moving around with this whole rotate thing like that, rather than doing it with the mouse, like, you have to hold down both mouse buttons to do it, but then it's only a pan, and to rotate it's like that. I know this is really kind of odd. I'm not totally cool with how that works. It's more the being able to zoom in and out like this by just moving the camera, rather than being able to use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. That feels rather strange. Tactical cam is not something I can ever get used to on this, well, with mouse and keyboard on Inquisition. Like, it seemed to work better on Origins, with the limited amount that I have played Origins and actually used the tactical cam in Origins. So that's kind of weird. This still feels like it's very much got the controller in mind, really, because I don't have any problem with the tactical camera on the controller. It seems to make sense, but this still feels very controllery. I wouldn't mind if they could make some tweaks to this, to like being able to zoom in and out with the mouse wheel in tactical camera. And I don't know. I suppose it makes sense to be able to move around with the WSA and D, and then rotate with. Well, I've got it set to Q and E because I've actually changed that because I prefer that. But it would feel weird if we were rotating with A and D to me personally. But I don't know. I feel like we should be able to move around more with the mouse. But like, if I double click there, the camera should maybe move there. But I don't know. I mean, at least you can select your party members, and like the camera snaps to them. And I would imagine if there was an enemy around here, we could click on them, and then the camera would snap to them. I would imagine that would happen. Let's actually get into some fights, shall we, and see if that does happen. And let's go back to the Inquisitor. There we go. Let's zoom in. There we go. So other than that, I mean, lots of little fixes, sort of stability fixes. I haven't noticed any crashes since the patch 2 came out. I will be honest, I have been playing quite a few hours previously and not had any crashes like we did do, so that's good. Here we go. Let's go to tactical camera. So click that. Okay, so the camera doesn't switch over there, but yeah, I suppose we are telling them to attack at least, aren't we? I suppose that's how that would work. So you are watching just an absolute noob use tactical camera here, and someone who doesn't generally use the tactical camera and is kind of getting used to it still. But hey, there we go. I have noticed any crashes yet, which is really good. Now, I've got to say that the problem with this is that I can't really talk about this without saying that I firstly upgraded my graphics card in the PC, and then I also happened to rebuild it completely. Like, I fresh installed a Windows, so therefore a fresh install of Origin and all that as well. So with that in mind, it's possible that any crashes that I was having before and performance problems were due to a less powerful graphics card, and maybe just, you know, a bunch of a Windows for the crud, basically. An install of Windows which is a few months old, so therefore full of a lot of crud. Or cruft, rather. So yeah, that's the thing. I can't really speak to that. But I've not noticed any crashing, and the performance seems great on my new graphics card, which of course it would do. Now, I upgraded my graphics card last week, so I did play a bit of this on the new graphics card, and the performance seemed good, but not as amazing as I was expecting it back then. Considering it's a 970, so you know, this is a pretty brand new graphics card. The cutscenes were still, although they are locked at 30 frames per second, I don't know, they always seemed really hitchy for me. There was nothing wrong with the dialogue, but they just seemed to be, it's almost like the computer seemed to be struggling to run the cutscenes, and they seem better now. They seem all good now, and I'm hoping that that's patch 2 that's fixed that. I think they're still running at 30 frames per second. They don't seem to be running at the same frame rate as the gaming still. So I think that's still a thing. They've still got the whole sync issues there. But they do seem to run better. So that's a good thing. Although this is all anecdotal, I haven't really got any evidence for this, and this is just how I'm sort of remembering how things were before the patch, and regards to now. But yeah, I mean the game it definitely seems to have better performance now, despite the new graphics card, from what I can remember pre-patch, if that makes any sense. This is almost not worth mentioning, seeing as I don't actually have any evidence to really prove any of this, but it feels like it's running better, at the very least. And of course, this is all running on Ultra and the highest graphical options, although I did turn off MSAA still, because that's just not my thing. The post-process anti-aliasing seems to look fine and seems to run really well. The multi-sample anti-aliasing, I noticed very little difference with this on, so I just left it off. But yeah, everything else is on Ultra and Fade Touch texture quality, which is really nice, by the way. The Fade Touch texture quality is absolutely amazing. And then everything else is Ultra and HB804 and so on and so forth. And yeah, it all looks very good and runs very well. I wish I had a FPS counter. I might have to do that in future when we do these sorts of things. Actually have some sort of metric for the frame rate. That is something I think I'm going to work on. But yeah, I suppose that's it really. That's all I really want to talk about. It's just technically this game seems to be getting better. I know lots of other people have had many more game-breaking issues and many more issues than I have, and that really sucks, because obviously no one likes a broken game, least of all the developers, I would imagine. I mean, if I was making a game, I certainly wouldn't want to be shipping a game that was crashing and having all sorts of technical problems. And I know BioWare really take pride in their work, so I can imagine they're not exactly happy about it either. But you know what? I'm really surprised actually that they've got this patch out there so quickly. And obviously they would have been working on some of these issues that this patch addresses before the game was even released, because of that development time and how things work when they're waiting for the games to get ratified for release and so on with Microsoft and Sony and so on and so forth. So obviously they've got that dev time, and I would imagine that some of these fixes in this patch would have been worked on back then. But it's nice to see that they've put in like the new feature with the whole technical camera thing. Again, it's only a small thing, but it's nice that they put it in there. I don't remember Mass Effect at all getting any kind of post-release tweaks like that and adding in new features. I only seem to remember them getting like bug fixes and things, so that's nice to see. Although, God, if just talking about that, I really wish Mass Effect 3 would have got some sort of controller support put in post-release. It just seems so weird. Just, I do not understand why that game does not have controller support. It seems just kind of obvious. But anyway, this video is not about that. So yeah, like I said, this is just going to be a short video. And it's just, I don't know, this game seems to be running better. I hope people who are having like game-breaking issues are having less of those issues now, and these bugs are getting fixed for them. Let me just think here. What was the other bug I experienced? The other bug I did experience was with, again, no spoilers, but the area of the game where there's a second character creator. After going through that character creator, the default voice of my Inquisitor changed to the original voice of the other voice of the Inquisitor, the other female voice. That's what I'm trying to say. And that appears to be fixed now, according to the change notes, although I am past that point in the game, so I can't really test that. So I'll have to start another new game, get to that point, and then see what happens there. So that's something we'll have to do, I guess. Hey everyone, so whilst editing this video, I actually thought that, you know what, I've got a save from around the point in time where there's the second character creator when you get to Skyhold. So we can actually test out this fix to see if it works. So yeah, this is going to be spoilers, obviously. I might edit this down just to cut out some of the dialogue and all that sort of stuff. But yeah, I mean, there will be spoilers here anyway. But okay, let's go talk to Varric, because this is what kicks this off. So yeah, there we go. So, custom champion of Kirkwall. Right, here we are. So, that's obviously Marion Hawk. Marion Hawk? Is that her name? I never played DA2, obviously, but yeah, I suppose this is Marion Hawk. So, obviously, we've got to make it custom in some way. Usually, I like to do a whole bunch of things the first time around, but I should imagine that just changing a couple of things would make the difference. So, oh, wow, let's do that. That's awesome. All right. Let's see what happens.
But after a while, all I could
so I should have the voice of Alex Wilton Regan still.
You're lucky it was just a single city.
Yeah, there we go. So, yep, that seems to have fixed it.
You're doing everything you can. Varric said that you.
I'm actually not sure who the other female voice is. So I need to look that up at some point because that feels kind of disrespectful to just refer to her as the other female voice. I'm not sure who that is. I need to look that up. Yeah, so far so good. We'll see what it's like after the cutscene. This cutscene also seems to be running much better. Like, again, seems to be a bit smoother. I'm not sure if it's 30 frames per second still. Maybe they're not. Maybe they were improved. They do seem to be better. Maybe they took the 30 frames per second cap off. Maybe they got the sync in right. It seems to be... I don't think they would have. That seems to be a big job for a short patch. So... Yeah, that's looking all good.
Inquisitor, what's been going on?
Yep, seems all good. I think this is fixed. I think this is all fixed. All right then, guys. Well, there we go then. I think this is that. I can confirm that bug is fixed. At least for me. I hope it's fixed for everyone else as well. Fingers crossed, eh? Right, back to the rest of the video. But yes, apparently that's fixed. That would be a good thing to fix because I know a lot of people would like to customize their other character that comes in that point of the game. Again, I'm desperately getting around spoilers there for anyone who actually still really cares about that. I mean, I suppose if you really care about this game, you probably already played it, but I don't know. I really hate having games spoiled for me, so that's or anything spoiled for me in that case. So that's how. That's how that goes. I'm ultra careful about spoiling games for people, or in fact any media for people really. Right, well, I think that's it, guys. Like I said, just a short video. Hope this has been somewhat useful. It's really kind of, I don't know, there's not a lot of hard evidence or hard information here for people, but I hope in one way or another this has been useful. So anyway, as always, guys, thanks very much for watching, and I will see you again next time.